أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه narrates that رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said أتاكم شهر رمضان شهر مبارك فرض الله عز وجل عليكم صيامه تفتح فيه أبواب السماء وتغلق فيه أبواب الجحيم وتغل فيه مردة الشياطين لله فيه ليلة خير من ألف شهر من حرم خيرها فقد حرم. In this beautiful hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is telling us something essential about Ramadan, that Ramadan is the month Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decided that we fast this month, and also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has gifted us so much in this month of Ramadan. He made many special things. Let's first describe Ramadan. Ramadan is one of the five pillars of Islam. It's not anything less than any of the other pillars. It's in fact, it's an institution itself. Ramadan is one whole month of fasting. Ramadan is a training camp. It's an annual season. It's an annual camp that Muslims have to go through. And if we look at it, it's in fact, it's a very well focused time for ibadah, for worship. But it doesn't have only also one type of worship. It has fasting, it has prayers, it has Quran recitation, it has charity. It involves so much in it. In this training camp that starts with the first day of Ramadan and ends with the last, the person learns many lessons. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us some of the things that, or some of the outcomes that we should work to gain at the end of Ramadan. By the end of Ramadan, we should have things that we should be very careful to have it and not to lose this great annual opportunity, but to have that achieved. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran said, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ, so you may attain piety. And this is the utmost that we can attain. We need to train ourselves. We need to discipline ourselves. When we abstain from eating and drinking and our desires, that we discipline these selves that we have, that we tell ourselves that stop. Are you allowed to do that or not? During the day of Ramadan, when we are hungry or thirsty and we want to reach and take this thing to eat or something to drink, we tell ourselves stop. This is not time for breaking your fast yet. You are fasting. You're not supposed to do that. And also, when we are being provoked by somebody, so we retaliate or we answer back in improper form, the Prophet ﷺ told us, remind yourself that you are fasting. If someone starts a fight or an argument with you, don't respond to that and say, I'm fasting. I'm not going to engage in this because I'm fasting. So it's always a time to remind ourselves that I'm fasting. I should abstain from that. I should abstain from eating and drinking and other desires that I want to do. I learn how to control myself properly. So, but the rest of the year, when the rest of the year when you are hungry or thirsty and you reach out to eat something or drink something, you do it without much of hesitation. But in Ramadan, you learn that you need to stop and weigh these actions. Are they appropriate or not? Is this the time for it or not? So you teach yourself lessons every day of Ramadan until you get used to that and you come out of Ramadan well-disciplined, and you think of things before you just blindly doing it. Other months are not like Ramadan. Ramadan month is not like any other. Ramadan is a very special, and the reward of Ramadan, the reward of fasting properly of Ramadan, is also huge. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Hadith al-Qudsi, Allah said, every other deed, I declared the reward, except fasting. Fasting is for me, and I will decide, or I will declare the reward only in the hereafter. It's hidden because this is so much. Plus, because of fasting is also hidden, we don't know that if the person is fasting or not. The person may have eaten or had something to eat or had some drink or whatever without knowing the people from outside. But Allah knows best that this person is well disciplined, that this person protected his or her fasting. So Allah will reward for that. Also, the remaining part of the hadith, that beautiful hadith, is that in this month of Ramadan, there is one night, the night of Al-Qadr, Laylatul Qadr. This night is worth 1,000 nights or more. And those who can gain the benefit of this night are the lucky ones. And those who don't get it and they deprived from it are the losers, as the hadith says. This Laylatul Qadr is the night when the Quran was revealed initially. So this important night of Al-Qadr is a huge opportunity in Ramadan as well. So Ramadan is also special because of Laylatul Qadr. Ramadan is special because that's the night when the Quran was revealed. So this training camp, this session that we have is essential for every Muslim to go through and to gain the best out of it. You shouldn't be the same person when you finish Ramadan, just like before Ramadan. You have to have stronger iman, stronger faith, and also stronger body. Ramadan is not there to weaken our bodies. In fact, the person who's fasting would hurt their health or would affect or impeach or impact their health, they're not supposed to fast. Ramadan there is to help us, to help our bodies, not to weaken our bodies. A mother, a nursing mom, who fasting would not be good for them, they shouldn't fast. They can break their fast or they shouldn't fast, and they can also give in something in for feeding one person for every day they did not fast in Ramadan. And if they can make it up after Ramadan, that will be important to do it. But if people who are very old or very sick and they cannot fast after Ramadan, they just may put a fidya after, like during Ramadan or after Ramadan, to feed one needy person, or equivalent of that, or they can just give food to them. That is Ramadan. Ramadan is coming very soon. Ramadan is our opportunity to discipline ourselves and to come closer to Allah, that we may attain piety that we all need. Attain taqwa. Taqwa is the proper fear of Allah, proper awareness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that will gain his pleasure, will gain his acceptance. And Ramadan is our opportunity to do that. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us fast in Ramadan, do the duties of Ramadan, the prayers of Ramadan, the recitation of the Quran, the give the charity after finishing all the fasting of Ramadan. And may Allah accept it from us. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Wa salli Allahumma wa barik ala Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.